Hello everyone, in this aviation video I am going to discuss about basic jet engine. So the aim of this video presentation is to deliver basic information about jet engine, and my objective will be to cover its introduction part, on which cycle it works, family of jet engine, idea to each category of engine, advantages and disadvantages of jet engine, then its summary part. So at the end of this video session you will have some idea regarding jet engine. So what is jet engine actually? It is the reaction engine that discharges a fast moving jet which generates thrust by jet propulsion in accordance with Newton's second law and Newton's third law. Newton's second law indicates rate of change of momentum is directly proportional to the force applied, and Newton's third law indicates every action has an equal and opposite reaction. So thrust we are getting in aircraft is in forward direction, and thrust is the product of mass flow rate and the change in velocity. The change in velocity means jet velocity and the forward velocity of the aircraft. So thrust is equal to m dot into cj minus ca. Now gas turbine engine works on Brayton cycle, that is constant pressure cycle. Why it is known as constant pressure cycle? Because heat addition and heat rejection take place at constant pressure only. Brayton cycle involves four processes: isentropic compression process, constant pressure heat addition process, isentropic expansion process and constant pressure heat rejection process. Now in these three diagrams you can see this is open Brayton cycle, this is pressure volume curve and temperature entropy curve. Now open Brayton cycle, air will enter at high pressure into the compressor where it will get pressurized. That pressurized air will enter into the combustion chamber section where fuel is mixed with the help of fuel nozzle and ignited with the help of igniter. After that, combustion product will flow over the turbine section where expansion of gases take place and will leave the engine at very high velocity. So this is the principle of Brayton cycle. Now we will try to understand this principle based on this curve, pressure volume curve. Process 1 to 2 indicate constant entropy, means pressure is rising over here, that means it indicates the compressor section. 2 to 3 you can see constant pressure process is taking place, that is combustion chamber section, because heat is getting added at constant pressure. Now 3 to 4 you can see pressure is dropping, this is expansion process and it is for turbine section. Then 4 to 1 heat is getting rejected at constant pressure. Similarly in temperature entropy diagram, what is entropy actually? Entropy is degree of randomness. Now 1 to 2 temperature is rising, that is compressor section. 2 to 3 heat is getting added at constant pressure, that is combustion chamber section. 3 to 4 again temperature is getting reduced or dropping, so it will be at turbine section. Then 4 to 1 heat is getting rejected at constant pressure. Now family of jet engine: turbojet, turboprop, turbofan, turboshaft, ramjet, scramjet and pulsejet. Operating Mach number and altitude limitation of each engine. For turboprop, Mach number range is approximately 0.3 to 0.6 and altitude limitation will be 4 to 6 km. For turbofan engine, the Mach number range will be 0.6 to 0.9 and altitude limitation will be 6 to 11 km. So for our commercial airline, the Mach number will be 0.8 approximately. For turbojet engine, Mach number range is approximately 2.2 to 2.7 and altitude limitation will be 16 to 21 km. The key question arises over here, what about ramjet, pulsejet and scramjet? Since these three engines don't have rotating component like compressor and turbine, these engines will be used in missiles and rockets etc. Because these three engines will give better performance at high altitude and at high speed. So ramjet and pulsejet will have a operating Mach number range will approximately to 2 to 6 or 2 to 5. For a scramjet, Mach number will be higher than these two engines. Now basic part of jet engine: intake, compressor, combustion chamber, turbine and nozzle. These five parts will be there in turboprop, turbojet, turbofan, turboshaft engine. Now function of these component. Now air will enter into the engine at very high velocity, so it should be converted into a pressure energy, because if a high velocity air will enter into the combustion chamber section, then it may cause the flame out condition. So to prevent that, we are using intake and compressor part, so that velocity will get reduced and pressure will get increased. So intake will convert kinetic energy of the entering air into static pressure rise, which is achieved by ram effect. So it will act as a diffuser. Compressor section. Compressor compress the air as much as possible and increase the pressure. It may be of centrifugal or axial type. After compressor, the compressed air, that means pressurized air, will enter into the combustion chamber section, which converts the chemical energy of the fuel into the heating energy, which is later converted into work by the turbine. And in combustion chamber section only, that pressurized air will be mixed with fuel and burned with the help of igniter, and those combustion product will pass over the turbine section, and continuous combustion take place as constant pressure, because we are talking about jet engine only. So after combustion chamber, we are having turbine part where expansion take place. So turbine provide power to drive the compressor by expanding the gases entering from combustion chamber. At last, there will be a nozzle section from where gases will leave the engine at very high velocity with minimum total pressure loss by converting a gas thermal energy into kinetic energy. You can see in this diagram, this is a basic jet engine diagram where you can see compressor with number of stages, or we can say more number of stages compared to the turbine, and both are connected by the same shaft. This portion is known as nozzle and this portion is known as combustion chamber section. So air at high velocity enter into the compressor section where it will get pressurized. So velocity is reducing and pressure is getting increased. High pressure air will enter into the combustion chamber section where fuel is mixed with the help of fuel nozzle and ignited with the help of igniter. After that, those combustion gases will ejected over the turbine section where expansion take place. Expanding gases will pass or leave the engine at very high velocity compared to the air entering the engine. So nozzle is the part which will increase the velocity of the gases and will produce higher thrust. Higher jet velocity, higher thrust. Turbojet engine, it is a continuous flow engine, a smaller front area resulting in low drag and reduced ground clearance problem. Turbojet engine can produce thrust even under static condition also. Now long takeoff roll because of low takeoff thrust. And last point, it is best suited for high speed, high altitude and long distance flight. Now turboprop engine. In turboprop engine, the component like compressor, turbine and nozzle will be the same compared to the turbojet engine, but there will be extra propeller, large dia propeller will be in the front, which produces much higher thrust as compared to the core thrust. So here maximum thrust will be achieved by the propeller instead of the core section like compressor, turbine or nozzle. So propulsion in turboprop engine is accomplished by conversion of majority of gas stream energy into the mechanical power to drive compressor or propeller load. Only small amount of jet thrust is produced. Higher thrust is produced by increasing mass flow rate achieved by propeller. So we can say in turboprop engine, maximum thrust is achieved by propeller only. So turboprop engine will have high propulsive efficiency at low air speed, which falls off at high speed due to shock formation. So turboprop engine will have very, very high propulsive efficiency compared to all gas turbine engine. Now high takeoff thrust and shorter takeoff roll because of high propulsive efficiency, and because of large dia propeller, it will have high landing gear height, and will be because of large dia propeller, and to maintain ground clearance, we require landing gear, means landing gear height will create a problem and increased weight because there will be an issue about ground clearance. So we need to increase the landing gear height. Now large frontal area because of that propeller. This is the diagram of turboprop engine. You can see very, very large dia propeller and Remaining concept is same compared to turbojet. Air will enter into the compressor section, pressurized, then combustion chamber section will be there. After that combustion chamber section, those combustion gases will pass over the turbine and from the nozzle they will leave at very high velocity. But air jet thrust is very less compared to the propeller thrust. Propeller will produce much higher thrust compared to the jet thrust. Now turbofan engine. Here instead of large dia propeller, we are having ducted fan. So turbofan engine is used in high subsonic civilian aircraft. Turbofan engine is a combination of turbojet and turboprop. So it will provide advantages to commercial airline. How? Since turbojet produces much high jet noise, so in order to reduce jet noise, that is jet velocity, to overcome such situation, turbofan engine is a combination of turbojet and turboprop, taking advantages of both. In turbofan engine, ducted fan is mounted at the front. Now, in turbofan engine, we are getting thrust in two terms, that is hot thrust and cold thrust. Primary air produces hot thrust since passes through the compressor, combustion chamber, turbine and exhaust nozzle, means core section. Primary air will pass through the core section, while secondary air or bypass air will produces cold thrust as it flows around the engine. Now turbofan engine are described in terms of bypass ratio, which is the ratio of mass of cold air and mass of hot air. Bypass ratio is directly proportional to the thrust, so high bypass ratio turbofan engine will reduce air pollution since for given thrust engine burn less fuel. There's one limitation also with turbofan engine, that is separate thrust reverser are needed for hot and cold jet if they are separate. In turbofan engine we are getting thrust in terms of hot jet and cold jet, so there will be a requirement of thrust reverser that will be separate. Lighter than turboprop but heavier than turbojet because of the presence of that large dia propeller, turboprop will have higher weight, so it will be turbofan which is lighter than turboprop but heavier than turbojet because it will also have ducted fan. Now at low altitude fan is more efficient and at high altitude jet is more efficient than fan. So turbofan can maintain fairly same average efficiency over a wide range of speed, hence maximum efficiency than turbojet. This is the diagram for turbofan engine. You can see fan part. Now this is low pressure compressor which is connected with the shaft to low pressure turbine. Then high pressure compressor is connected to the high pressure turbine. This fan part, and this air is known as cold air, and this air will be known as hot air. Then hot air and cold air together will produce a thrust. Now turboshaft engine. Turboshaft engine work on the free turbine concept, that we can say in helicopter we are using free turbine concept. In turboshaft engine, air will enter into the compressor section, then compressed air will enter into the combustion chamber section where fuel is mixed and burned with the help of igniter. After that, those combustion gases will ejected over the turbine part, that is known as compressor turbine. Those expanded gases, now turbine will expand those gases, so expanded gases will pass over another turbine, that is known as free turbine or power turbine. That power turbine will rotate and provide rotation to the helicopter rotor. So this is known as free turbine concept because in other gas turbine engine like turbojet, turboprop and turbofan engine, the gases will leave the nozzle with very high velocity, but in turboshaft case we are using those expanded gases to operate another turbine. Now turboshaft engine has high power, low weight and are universally used. Jet thrust is not critical here since turboshaft engine are designed to produce maximum available shaft power, and it is a modified form of turboprop engine. Now ramjet engine. In ramjet engine, I have already discussed there is no compressor and no turbine, so less noise. Ramjet cannot operate at a static condition as there is no pressure rise in a diffuser, hence it is a not self-propelling engine. Thus, to initiate its operation, it must be launched by an airplane. Unlike other gas turbine engine, it needs some launching device. Now, ramjet have high thrust per unit weight of engine among all air breathing engine. Air breathing engine means all jet engine are air breathing engine only. Supersonic and subsonic diffuser are used at the entry of ramjet engine. Now, due to high air speed, the CC means combustion chamber require flame holder to stabilize the flame. You can see the diagram of this ramjet engine. This portion is known as this portion is known as oblique shock inlet. Why we are using this? Just to produce two or three oblique shock with one normal shock. You can see this normal shock. Why we want those shock wave to produce over here? Just to get operating Mach number suitable inside the combustion chamber, because for ramjet engine we are using supersonic Mach number greater than 1. So if the air will enter into the CC at very high velocity or very high Mach number, then it may cause the flame to blow off. So for that purpose we are using flame holder also. So with the help of these shock wave we can eliminate supersonic condition inside the combustion chamber, and because of here there will be a supersonic diffuser and then subsonic diffuser. They both will reduce the velocity of the air by converting those kinetic energy into pressure rise. After that, Mach number which will be higher at the front, that will be approximately 2 or 3, it will be 0.2 approximately in combustion chamber section, so that continuous combustion and efficient combustion can be achieved. And at last there will be a CD nozzle which will produce a high jet velocity and high thrust. Now, Pulsejet engine, it works on the Otto cycle. This is the only engine in other air breathing engine compared to other air breathing engine. It is the only engine which works on Otto cycle. Subsonic diffuser, spring loaded flapper valve grid or shutter valve are present in Pulsejet engine. Due to the presence of flapper valve grid, Pulsejet engine is self starting engine. Very short life of flapper valve grid. Presence of flapper valve grid make it less reliable. Due to excessive noise, it is preferred in pilotless aircraft like bomber, German V1 known as buzz bomb. See, Pulsejet engine is self-starting engine because of the presence of flapper valve grid. But because of this flapper valve grid, it is less reliable because the life of flapper valve grid is very very less. What is Otto cycle? Otto cycle is constant volume cycle, means in Brayton cycle I told that constant pressure heat addition and constant pressure heat rejection take place. In Otto cycle, constant volume heat addition and constant volume heat rejection will be there. Generally our piston engine aircraft works on Otto cycle. This is the diagram of Pulsejet engine. You can see these are the shutter valve or flapper valve grid. Air will strike those valve and enter into the engine. So combustion chamber portion is there. After that, this nozzle portion or tail jet pipe, because of its high noise production, we are using jet pipe propelling nozzle. Now, advantages of jet engine. Mechanical efficiency of jet engine is high. Speed of jet engine per horsepower is higher. Ignition and lubrication system are much simpler in jet engine compared to piston engine, where lot of reciprocating components are present. In jet gas turbine engine, there are less reciprocating components, so ignition and lubrication system are much simpler. Demerits or disadvantages: difficult to start, obviously. Then turbine blades need special cooling system due to high temperature, because in combustion chamber approximately 2000 Celsius temperature is preferred. So turbine blade have to face very very high temperature. For that special material is required, like nickel super alloys we are using, or nickel based alloy we are using. So for that special cooling system is also needed. And thermal efficiency of jet engine is low because heat power in combustion chamber is very very high, and thermal efficiency is the ratio of output power to the heat power, and heat power is very high, so thermal efficiency is inversely proportional to heat power. If heat power is very very high, obviously thermal efficiency will be very very low. Summary: whatever I've told, that jet engine is a mechanical device which produces thrust based on Newton's second law and third law. Then I discuss about Brayton cycle, because gas turbine engine works on Brayton cycle, that is constant pressure cycle. Then I discuss about category of engine like turbojet, turboprop, turbofan, turboshaft. Then also ramjet, scramjet and pulsejet. After that I discuss about their Mach number and altitude limitation, where I should mention commercial airline operate Mach number on 0.8, then turbofan engine is preferred. Then ramjet, pulsejet and scramjet engine do not have any rotating part. So friends, this much only for this presentation. In this presentation I try to cover all the basic details about all category of engine. So hope that you might have some idea now about all these engines. Thank you.